South Street near some of the old haunts of Joey, Skinny Joey Marino, the former mob boss of Philadelphia. Joey is in Florida and is telling anyone and everyone who will listen he's not coming back. But he just got off of house arrest. He's now out on his own. And the talk coming up from Florida is he hopes to open a bar restaurant. Now, he was a habitué of bar restaurants here in Philadelphia. Not an owner, but a frequent customer. Here on South Street, at the Continental, at 2nd and Market, and along Delaware Avenue. Joey and an entourage of wise guys back in the day, back in the 1994, 95, that era. Now he's done 14 years on racketeering charges. Everything I'm hearing is he's doing very well. I'm told he's living in a condo in the Boca Raton area, 4 bedrooms, 2 baths, worth about 400 grand. And he's become part of the scene in South Florida. Others say he intends to open a bar restaurant, which is an interesting development given the fact that he's got a career criminal record and he probably would have trouble getting a liquor license. But I suspect he'll work out some situation where he's part of a restaurant operation down there. One of the things about Joey is, while he doesn't want to come back to South Philadelphia because of intense law enforcement scrutiny, I think he's always enjoyed the spotlight and the limelight and the celebrity, and he can certainly find that there as well. And that leads us to another development. According to a report in Dan Gross's column in the Daily News last week, Joey has begun discussing with some individuals about doing a movie based on his life. This comes right on the heels of Ralph Natale, the former mob boss, trying to shop a memoir. Joey and Ralph were two guys who enjoyed being center stage. And while they're no longer part of the underworld, it looks as if they want to stay in that milieu where people know who they are, they know what they're doing. Now, Joey's got problems, I would say, in terms of telling his story because of the kind of things he was involved in. If he wanted to tell a real story, people would want to know what really happened at Dante and Luigi's on Halloween night in 1989 when Nicky Scarfo Jr. was shot. Joey Marino has long been suspected of being the shooter that night. He's never been charged, never been prosecuted. What's he going to say about that? What happened that morning at the Warfield Luncheon Express when, picked up on FBI video, two cars drove past, four individuals rushed into the luncheonette, shot Joe Ciangolini, then ran back out. Nobody has been convicted in that case. It was part of the racketeering case in which Marino and six associates were tried back in 2001, but the jury found not enough evidence to bring a conviction. Nevertheless, those things sit out there, and it's part of Joey's story. Does he want to talk about that? Can he talk about that? Can he talk about unsolved murders or attempted murders, crimes that haven't been prosecuted? Does he put himself in a jackpot by doing that? He's contacted Leo Rossi, who's made several movies, one of which was Tenth and Wolf, probably one of the worst gangster movies ever made. It was based loosely on Joey's life. The limelight shines, but it doesn't distinguish. If you want to tell your story, if you want to be a celebrity, you put yourself in a situation where people are going to ask more and more questions, and given the criminal nature of what Joey's life used to be, it could end up being problematic for him. So while he probably is not coming back to Philadelphia to seek that limelight, it appears as if he wants the spotlight in South Florida. Whether he gets it remains to be seen.